Hello dear students, welcome you on the Vidyajis Vidya Sankul e-learning class of standard 9th science. In today's lecture we are going to start our next chapter, and that will be the chapter number 30, and that will be called as the why do we fall ill. So in this chapter, first of all we are going to start with the basic summaries that gives you the definitions regarding why should we are falling ill. Ill means what? Means if we have a headache, if we have some kind of anxiety issue, if we have some kind of psychotic issue. So that's types of issues, why should that created in our body? Also there are some kinds of different thing that will be happening. There are some mentally issues will be happening in our body. There are some physical issues will be happening in our body. So during this whole time, how can we say that why these depressing thoughts, this physical damage in our body, this disease syndrome will be occurred in our body? So what are the purpose and what are the reasons that we are falling ill? It means we are getting reduce our health in our socialism. So for that reasons and consequences are what? So for that we are going to study this chapter. So first we will start from the basic definitions regarding what is the health, what is the disease, what is called as the ill. Okay, there are lots of definitions regarding the disease or health, because we generally understand that health is generally the term that we are using for identifying the our natural syndromes, okay, from our body. But generally health is consists the two types of definition. So there is one health based on the socialism, it means our problem based on our society, and another health that will be based on the our mind consisting syndrome. Okay, so it will happen during our mentally dependent on the mentally, and the physically definitions are the both the difference for the health. So we are going to start that from the first part, that is a definition, and afterwards what we are going to see in this chapter, that we are going to see the different types of disease, different types of syndrome that will be happening due to the anxiety issues, many more psychological issues. So there are lots of diseases will be happening, and in that we are going to see the first infectious disease. What are called as the infectious disease, what are called as the uninfectious disease or acute disease, these types of disease which we are going to study in this chapter. Afterwards we are going to discuss the what are the consequences that we are facing during the illness in our body. If we are falling ill, then what happened in our body, what type of thought created in our body, what type of issues created from our body, what type of physical damage will be created during this disease infection in my body or in our body. We are going to see that in this chapter, okay. And then last, after all the whole discussion regarding the illness, disease, consequences, we are going to make sure that how to prevent this illness in our body. How to make sure that we don't get the disease syndrome, we don't get any kind of syndrome in our body. So how to prevent that types of all the illness in our body, we have to see that in the last topic, okay. So we'll begin with the first topic, that will be health and its failure. Now what is the health? So I have already told you that there is an different kinds of definition for the health. The first definition that satisfies us, that health is the state of physical, mental and social well-being. Now it is a kind of a state, like we have seen in the chapter number 1 for the we have seen that what are the matters. Okay, so we have seen that matters are made up from the particles, okay, and matters have the three basic state, and that will be solid, liquid and gas. We have seen that, okay, from the basis of the structure we have seen the state. It means health is also a state, but for what state? It will be the state of the physical, mental and the social well-being. How I should behave, or how my body will behaving physically, mentally as well as socially, okay. How well my body is doing a work or I can say that how well my body is active in the mental state, in the physical state, or in the social state. So what are the physical means, if I am doing the exercise, then if my body refuse to do the exercise, it means I have some kind of physical state, then I can say that I have some kind of health issues in my physical body. Okay, if I want to do some kind of work, but there is a lots of anxiety issues in my body, so I can say if I don't like to do that work, then it will be came from the mental issues from our body, and that is also created the syndrome in our health, in our health. And last one is the social. So if the physical health of my body is well, if my mental health is well, okay, but what about the society? If the societies or if the our surroundings will create some kinds of nuisance, and from that the some of the things will affect my health, then it will be also considered in the state of the health. And that's why it is considered in the state of the health, because sometimes if you hear that the whenever you are sitting at home, and if you hear the some of the vehicles came around the home and they are continuously knocking the horn, if they are pressing the horn button continuously, then you feel some after some time you feel very anxious, and you feel that you feel aggressive in your body. In it also gets the disastrous lookout to your health. Okay, so this also creates the unwell being in our body. Okay, so we can say that very easily that health is a state. But for what state? So it is a state for the physical. It means my body, whatever the work I am doing, if that is the work is not sufficiently do from my body, then I can say that my health is unwell. Also from the mental illness, if I am not feeling well, if my body is refuse to do any kind of work, then it is my mental state. Okay, and there is a social. It means these our surroundings will create some kinds of situation to affect our health. So this is the very important definition for the health. Another point that we are discussing is the condition necessary for the good health. This is the important point that we are discussing. Now first point that we are looking for is, how can we say that we are in the good state of the health? What was the ideas, or what was the points that can decide that our health is good? So here are the points: good physical and social environment. If I have been provided with the good physical and the social environment, then I can say that my health is very well. My health is good because my body is doing physical work properly, and the social environment is also significant to cover up my body's issues. So that's why I can say that it has a good, if it requires the good physical and the social environment for the good health. Second is the good economic condition. So if I don't have the money, then obviously I have to suffer for my body, because if the money is not the sufficient, then what happened? Then I cannot buy the food, I cannot eat the food, then my body is starting to unwell, and then the health is well as going downwards into the our body. Likewise, we can say that for the, if the money is not enough, then we cannot provide the sufficient amount of the food to our families, and for them we are social, and also we are making the social environment very bad for them. Okay, so this is the must needed condition, that it requires the good economic condition. Okay, and if the economic conditions of the whole country is very well, then no one is poor, and then no one is poor, and then no one will be die for from eating the less food. Because in today's generation or today's day-to-day life, we are seeing that lots of people are dying from suffering from not getting the proper amount of food in their bodies, and that's why they are dying. Okay, so we have to make sure that all the economic conditions are good for our human beings. Okay, social equality and harmony. Sometimes you hear that they are above us, they are below us, these types of casteism will create a very much insignificant to our health, because in our subconscious mind and in our conscious mind we have look at the people in a different way. Like if the Piyuna is working, then we are seeing him as him or her, we are seeing as they are below us, so we are not treating them well, so their health is also going to unwell and our health is also going to unwell. From that perspective, we are going to discuss that we are going to give the equality to each and every person, and these types of issues are happening in a very from the past, very fast, very few years from the past. Okay, like we can say that 30 or 40 years, this is the system that we are still fighting for it, that how can we give the equality to all. In today's time, we can say that the woman empowerment is going at the higher rate, so we are giving the equal chances to the woman. So for that, we can say that we are improving day by day, and we are improving in our all the issues that we are facing on. But we can say that the inequality gives the disastrous damage in our health. Okay, like if I am Nipun, see, if example for I am Dipyun, and if someone is treating me not well, then I already think about the negative impact created in my mind, that this person is not okay, this person is not treating me well. So first one is starting to break down the mental health in my body. Afterwards, what happened in my body, that I am not doing the work properly, then the physical health is also get damaged. These are the things that you have to remember for the social equality and the harmony. Okay, good physical and social environment includes clean surrounding. It means the physical and social environment, it includes the clean surrounding, good sanitization. This is the most required condition in today's generation, in today's scenario. Okay, so if the sanitization is not proper, it creates the disease or the viruses that are flowing into the air in today's time. So we have to be very, very careful about the sanitization. So we have to make sure the place that we are sitting or that we are going to for a picnic or wherever we are going, they are very well sanitized, and we have to look out for that. Proper garbage disposal and clean drinking water gives us the good physical and the social environment. Another point, good economic condition includes the job opportunities for all, for earning to have the nutrition to food and to lead to a healthy life. I already discussed that point. Social equality and harmony are also necessary. Also, we have discussed that point. We are going to the next point, and that will be the difference between the healthy and the disease-free. See, these are both the different point and both are the different things. First is the healthy. Healthy means, if I am healthy, it doesn't mean that I have, if I am not very well healthy, then it doesn't mean that I have gotten some kind of disease in my body. It doesn't need, or it doesn't mean to say that I have a disease, because disease is a other type of category that we are discussing. While healthy is the state of mentally or physically in our well-being, while disease-free is the state of absence of disease in my body. See, if I have a cough, okay, then I have a disease in my body, but still my body is doing in enough work, still my body is do any kind of work, my mental situation is very well strong, so I can say that I am a healthy person, but with a disease. Okay, see the difference between both of them. That healthy doesn't require a disease in present in our body. Okay, if you are unhealthy, then it doesn't mean that you have a disease in your body. Okay, because disease is a different thing. It refers to the individual physical and the social environment, while disease-free is the refers to the only to the individual. The individual has a good health, while the individual may have a good health or a poor health. We can say that. In this, what types of things that affect us? So our individualism is affect the health, physical and the social environment affect the health. In this, disease is only caused in my body. I am not doing the, if I have a disease, I am not passing to anyone. See, if I passing the viruses, if you think that sir, coronavirus is passing from one person to another person, it is passing because it is a virus. Okay, so if I have a disease, so that refers that it, I have the disease. I cannot say that the whole society or the whole physical environment gets the disease because of me, or they are giving me a disease. But if you think that, okay, let us discuss that into the point that if someone is knocking horn around your house, then what happens? Then it creates the anxious issues in your body. Then after some time you thought that you have to go outside and tell him that please stop the knocking of horn. Okay, you make sure that this situation is now going to stop. Whatever the thing you need to do to going this situation stop, you are going to do that. Okay, but that doesn't mean you got the disease. Okay, it doesn't say that you have a fever. Because of the horn knocking, it doesn't signifies you that you have a fever. But whenever you get the fever, what happened during your body? Whenever you get the fever, it consists only in your body. You cannot blame anyone for that, that there is a physical or the social well-being created the fever in me. Because it creates the syndrome in your body. And that syndrome will be consist within your body, and it only refers to you because you are individualism for, and you are only responsible person for that. Okay, afterward the individual has a good health. It means this signifies us that the individual person has a good health. I have already tell you that if you got the anxious issue or anxiety issues, or if you get the neuropsychotic syndromes in your body, that doesn't defines you that you can do the health issues or you being the unhealthy because of that. Okay, you are the individually can solve this problem. Okay, but disease need disease. The individual may have a good health or poor health. You can signifies that. Okay, we'll discuss that in another part. That what does disease look like? Now the disease are look like the, there are some kinds of symptoms will be happening in our body, like whenever the cough or whenever the disease like the cough or the wherever the disease happen in your body, then it creates the symptoms in your body, like your nose will bleeding, or your you are getting the sneezing, or whatever the things, you get the headache. Okay, so these types of thing will be happening, or these types of symptoms will be occur during the whatever the disease come in your body, like we have seen in the current situation that coronavirus is going on, and it creates the symptoms in our body, like our throat is getting damaged, then our lungs will not getting the breathe in or breathe outside. Other thing that will be happening during the coronavirus, you get the headache, you get the fever, physical weakness comes in your body. So these types of symptoms will come, and that signifies us that you caused or you have got the some kind of disease in your body. So when a person is affected by a disease, either the normal functions or the appearance of the one or more system of the body changes for the worse, these changes give rise to the signs of the disease called the symptom. Okay, whenever you got the disease, you feel the some kinds of symptoms for it. Otherwise, you whenever you are doing the some of the things naturally, you don't feel any kind of symptoms in your body. And if the symptoms are come, then you can say that you got the disease. Okay, so for the any particular disease, they all have the different kinds of symptoms. Like whenever you got the fever, you get it, the temperature heated in your body. Okay, but there is no nothing like that happened in the jaundice. Okay, whenever you got the jaundice, it doesn't mean that you got the fever. Okay, so all the different kinds of disease got the all the different kinds of symptoms into that. We are going to discuss the types of disease, and that are the acute disease and the chronic disease. Now, what is the acute disease? If these are disease which last only for a short period, it means they are the cold, cough, typhoid and cholera. These are the things that will come in your body and will stay for a short times of duration. It will be generally it can be released in outside from your body into 3 or 5 days. Okay, after 3 or 5 days you will feel better in your system, and you can say that you are now healthy person. Okay, So acute disease are the disease that is come in your body for the 3 to 5 days or for the short time, while chronic disease are affect your body for the long term. So like diabetes, tuberculosis, elephantiasis, arthritis, these are the things, or the cancers. These are all the disease that will be come in your body, and it will stay so longer in your body that it will be goes from your body well when you are going to die. Okay, like the cancer has no precautions, or we cannot prevention of the cancer. So for that purpose, what we are going to do, we are going to treat them well. And the patients who got the cancer, now there are lots of things to reducing this cancer. Okay, there are lots of things is going on, okay, for reducing the cancer and to prevent the cancer. Okay, like that diabetes is also came once in your body, and then it will stay to 20 to 40 years in your body. No precautions or no prevention will be occurred during this diabetes. Okay, you have to take the insulin injection if you got the diabetes. Then you can eat the some amount of sugaring food in your body. Otherwise, you cannot eat the sugaring food or more salty food, because it gets the diabetes rate increased, or it will get the diabetes rate decreased. Okay, tuberculosis, it means you get the TB. It gives you the cold or the cough for the very long time. Okay, if you are sneezing or if you are coughing for a very long time, it means you got the tuberculosis disease. And tuberculosis disease will consume you for more than 10 or 12 years. And then afterwards, you need to prevent, or if you need to make sure that you have to prevent yourself from that tuberculosis, you need to do the operations or do the other kinds of scenario. Then you will get the reduction in the tuberculosis. There is no prevention or precautions for the tuberculosis or cancers, but still, if you want to manage them, you can treat them well, and then they will boost up your life. Okay, and the last topic we are going to see, the infectious disease, and that will be you can see that in current situation the coronavirus are infectious, because it will transfer from one human being to another human being. So spread from the infected person to a healthy person, those diseases are called as the infectious disease. And the mediums to transfer the syndromes or the disease or the virus are the air, water, food, vectors, physical contacts or sexual contact. This will transfer the amount of disease from one person to another person, and these are called as the medium, like air, water, food. From the air, if the transportation of happening of the disease from the water, from the food, from the vectors. Now, what are the vectors? We can say that whatever the insect, sometimes if you hear that the fly comes on your food and that they eat the food, and then it goes to the second food, and then if you eat that food, then you got the disease. Then they transfer the some amount of disease from food to another food, and that makes you ill. Okay, so those are the things that transfer the disease from one point to another point. Those are called as the vector. By the physical contact or the sexual contact, you can understand very well that these types of disease also will be happening. These are the examples that common cold, chickenpox, mumps, measles, typhoid, cholera, these are the things that will be considered in the infectious disease. And in the non-infectious disease means they are not infected at all. It will not transfer from one person to another person. And there are some of the examples regarding the non-infectious disease are beriberi, rickets, succory, night blindness, diabetes. These are the things that will not transfer from one person to another person. Okay. In the next lecture, we are going to see about the causes of the disease. Okay. So that's it for today. Thank you very much for reading this lecture. If you had any kind of doubt, you can ask me on the comment section. You can ask me on the personally on my WhatsApp number. Till then, bye bye everyone, and take care of yourself.